Hey, Yorktown family. Thanks for taking the time to watch this short video. I'm up on this lift in the worship center to try to get your attention to watch the video, but to remind us of an event that we're having Sunday night on our property, and I'm going to be on this lift in the parking lot, but I'll get to that in a moment. You know, during the season, do you find yourself agitated by those who do evil or envious of evildoers? Apparently, this was a lifelong issue because David, in Psalm 37, which was a part of our reading plan this week, he's addressing those who might tend to lean that way, again, to be agitated by evildoers. Now, what he's reminding us of is that there is coming a day when everyone will stand before God and give an account. So I encourage you to go read Psalm 37. It's very encouraging in light of all that's going on today. But I just want to read a portion of it right now. He says, don't be agitated by evildoers and do not envy those who do wrong, for they wither quickly like grass and wilt like tender green plants. He says, refrain from anger and give up your rage. Don't be agitated. It can only bring harm. And so I want us to all take a deep breath. Again, go read Psalm 37. Again, reminds us not to take matters into our own hands, that we need to leave room for the judgment and the wrath of God. But later in that psalm, he encourages us to take refuge in the Lord, to delight ourselves in the Lord. So that's what I would encourage you to do, to take refuge in the Lord, to delight in the Lord and to rest in him and to realize that he has a plan and he's got all things in control. Let me say once again, thank you for all the birthday wishes. I was quite overwhelmed with the drive-through, drive-by birthday greetings, the cards that you sent me, the encouraging, affirming words. It's a highlight of my almost 12 years here. And so thank you for, again, the affirmation. Let me update you on some of our regathering dates. We're looking on August the 30th, Sunday, to have childcare for the 10:45 service only. Again, this is getting us prepared for the next stage of our regathering. But August the 30th, we're having childcare for birth through kindergarten at the 10:45 service only. Also, we're looking to regather fully on Sunday, September the 13th, to resume all of our Bible fellowships, to have kids' church at 10:45, and to have childcare for both services at 9 and 10:45. Again, this is all subject to change given the climate, so make sure that you stay aware or stay tuned for ongoing updates. This Sunday morning, our service is going to be a little out of the ordinary. I don't want to give too much away, but we're designing the platform to be more of a living room feel, to where we're gathering around the piano and singing some classic worship songs. Adam will be leading the first part of our worship. He's asked me in the latter part to sit down at the piano and to lead another segment or section of worship. So we encourage you to be here Sunday morning, and if you can't be, to certainly watch it online as we stream it live at 9 o'clock. I'll be sharing a message called Preparing, which means that we're preparing for what God longs to do by praying, and I'm going to share a story out of Acts chapter 12, so you'll want to be here for that and continue to pray for us if you would. Now, the reason I'm on this lift is because that's where I'm going to be Sunday night when you get to the parking lot at 6:45 at the culmination of our Get Out and Pray initiative. As you well know, we're asking you at 5 o'clock to get in your cars with your family and go to centers of influence like City Hall, the police department, to the respective schools at which your kids might attend, to some businesses that you might frequent or own or that you know need some help from God. And so we're asking you to go to those center of influences and pray. And we've sent out some packets. You should have already received those with further instructions. Also, some prayer suggestions for those centers of influence. We'll also be sending out some videos from our city leaders encouraging you to pray for specific areas. And then at 6:45, we're asking you to be here at the parking lot. And we're going to ask you to tune in to 87.7. The radio frequency that we'll be airing on, and we'll be praying for a few minutes for not only Yorktown, but for the church at large in Corpus Christi. So again, stay tuned for more updates. You can go to our new app. It's church.app. If you go to the app store, church.app, and then you can look for the Yorktown application. There it will have more instructions and also the prayer suggestions for our time Sunday night. So we're looking forward to that. We again pray that it would be synergistic, effectual, and powerful. But let's continue to pray for God to move powerfully during this season. So we hope to see you not only Sunday night, but Sunday morning. God bless you and make it a great weekend.